Cycling advocate attorney Raymond Fortun presented before the House Committee on Public Order and Safety a second CCTV footage of the road rage incident along Quezon Avenue last August 8th. From the video angle, a red sedan is seen encroaching on the bicycle lane, cutting a cyclist. The cyclist tried to avoid the vehicle by switching lanes, but the car also moved in the same direction. The driver stopped his car, got off, and hit the cyclist with his hand. The driver then pulled out his gun and cocked it. The video also shows him dragging the bicycle to the curbside. That driver has since been identified as Wilfredo Gonzalez, a dismissed cop.
In this agreement, it would appear that there was a charge and a counter charge. The charge was reckless imprudence resulting in damage to property on the part of Mr. Gonzalez, and a counter charge of grave threat. Two videos will not lie.
But in a statement sent to ABS-CBN News, the biker asserted he and Gonzalez have peacefully resolved the issue last August 8th and that there was no money involved. He also says it was his own decision not to file a complaint against Gonzalez, who threatened him with a gun. He asks the public to respect his decision, adding he wants to put the issue to rest because of the stress it has cost him and his family. Quezon City Police Station 11 also told the panel that the cyclist was not coerced to settle. As proof, the QCPD chief submitted to the committee and to Fortun copies of CCTV footages from the police station where they were brought after the altercation. But at least one lawmaker challenged the claim of the Quezon City Police.
Hindi under duress yung siklista at hindi po siya pinilit na makipag-ayos doon kay Mr. Gonzalez.
Kung isang tao na isang siklista ang makakaharap niya sa police station ay isang dibaril at kasama ng mga police na nandun dati, sino ang dihado?
QCPD Chief Brigadier General Nicholas Torre III meanwhile admitted he had lapses for appearing in a press conference with Gonzalez last Sunday, which drew flack from netizens and even from QC Mayor Joy Belmonte. On Wednesday morning, Torre resigned from his post as QCPD Chief and requested that it be effective on Thursday.
I am aware of the very negative backlash that I've been receiving in the social media, and we are very sensitive to that. I just can't afford to drag the organization with me. I'm a team player, so voluntarily I am asking my boss to remove me from this post. The way I handle it, on the hindsight, pati ako, I think I could have done it better.
Palagay ko isa sa mga lapses mo ito. We have to consider the feelings of our citizenry, no?
I do agree with you that I had committed some lapses on that matter. That's the reason why it really fueled my decision to shield the organization and especially QCPD from the backlash in the social media that's been happening right now.
The QCPD on Tuesday filed an alarms and scandals complaint against Gonzalez.
Kung wala tayong complainant, then wala tayong criminal case. Yung kanilang case of alarms and scandals, I have very serious doubts, no, whether it will prosper. Napakadami po ng mga objections, no, under our rules on electronic evidence that can be put into play. Ang penalty po sa alarms and scandals, pag tinignan niyo po ang revised penal code, 1 to 10 days.
Fortun urged the House Committee to launch a full investigation in aid of legislation and craft new laws that will further protect cyclists. Among his suggestions is a presumption of liability in the event an altercation occurs in a bike lane. In the meantime, the Supreme Court confirmed on Wednesday that Gonzalez was an employee of the Office of Associate Justice Ricardo Rosario, but his employment was immediately terminated on August 27 upon discovery of the incident. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.